gentlemen. Thank you.
Because I'll watch that stuff and my eyes will start welling up. And I'm like, what the?
You're not the only ones crying when we're crying. It's funny, because every now and again, we'll get to watch one of the episodes, you know, like it'll be shooting, it'll be during the season, and we'll sneak back to one of our trailers to kind of try and stay in tune with the episode. And I'll sneak a look at him every now and again, and he's kind of like, if Dean has his angry face on, Jensen does too. And if Dean's joking, Jensen's like,
I'm laughing at myself. That was so good.
No, but you remember getting into that headspace, right? And so you remember your attitude. So if you ever, we should do it sometime. We should all watch an episode of Supernatural.
Yeah!
That would be fun. I wouldn't want to watch
CP! Breakfast Day!
And in fact, you know what? Let's just watch episodes for the rest of the day. Is that?
I would love to watch French Mistake now. However, it would be nice to watch an emotional one. We did. We won. Swan song. You're killing me. You're killing me. We did watch. We did watch fan fiction. Was anybody there? Was anybody there at the Jared episode party that was in Los Angeles? Anybody make it? I can't see. No, I don't think so. Yeah, they had like a raffle, and so we watched fan fiction with some fans who had signed up to be a part of it. That was kind of neat. It was a neat kind of all-inclusive experience, but we'll have to do it someday coming up. All right. Baby? Oh, yeah. Are you calling me baby?
Oh, baby.
Is that a song? Don't call me baby.
No, it's not. You know how I know it's not a song? Because they didn't start playing. Thank you, guys.
It is.
It's Here's Mike's number, Call Me Maybe.
No, but there's a different one. It's like a, I don't know.
Can you stop talking?
I will. We have to start. Hi, I can see a shadow.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Olivia.
Jared. That's Jared.
So, like Jensen was saying, you guys have really emotional scenes on the show. So I was wondering, what you do to prepare for them. Like, and how do you really connect with them to make it like as realistic a performance as it can be?
Thank you.
Yeah.
For me, when we do an emotional scene, one of the things I hate the most as an actor is if the writer writes, they break down. Or Sam starts to cry, or something like that. I hate it. Because then you feel like you're locked into it. I've had scenes of Sam where I was supposed to cry, or it was written that I cried, and I didn't. And I had scenes where I wasn't supposed to cry, and I did, right? So I feel like I know Sam enough to know when he's gonna break down.
Yeah.
And he cries a lot, Sam does. But don't call me baby. So for me, it's telling a story, right? At least for me. I think it's if it makes sense for the story, but you just play it for real. You know, I like Sam a lot. I'm his friend. He's my friend. He has great hair. So that's me.
10 years of this crap.
How's my what?
How do you like this morning?
No, let's not. Let's not. It didn't wash off. Yeah, that's right. He stains. I think Jared will agree with me. The getting to an emotional state in a scene for Sam or Dean, I think it's evolved over the years because we've evolved with the characters and we've been there. So in the beginning, I think we would probably, I know, like, for Heart, going back to that, like, you had to think of something in your own life to get you upset, and then did the scene. Now I don't think we have to think about things in our personal life. I think we actually are so, we're so in tune with these characters and the story that that it's easy for us to feel what these characters would feel in that particular situation. So, it doesn't make it any easier to do the scene, but it's certainly a different method, I guess. So,
yeah.
Thank you.
You're back.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Macy.
Hi.
I have a question for
Jared.
Yeah. How are y'all doing today?
How we doing?
I'm good, yeah.
Oh.
had the chance. So you've had the chance to work with several amazing actors and directors and writers, and I was wondering if is there any person that you guys really want to work with on or off the show, like be actor, writer, anybody?
Who we've already worked with, or just in
or
general?
Or someone else you have that you would like to work with?
I mean, a bunch. I'd love to have Zach Levi on the show. I mean, he's doing Heroes now, which is cool. But Steven?
I think he's got enough crossovers going on right now. He doesn't.
We have Donald Trump.
Yes.
His name is Dick Roman.
I'm not sure there's anything in the lore that's going to help us handle that hair.
We have a hair off.
I don't know. You know what I thought of the other day? I thought would be fun is
Daniil.
She'd be fun to have on. I was saying Michael Rosenbaum. Some of you remember him from Smallville. I don't know why, but I just thought of that.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Hi.
I'm
Amanda, and I was wondering if your characters from Dark Angel and Gilmore Girls, how would they react if they were in the Supernatural?
I wasn't on Dark Angel.
In the shows.
I'll go first. It's a common misconception. That was actually Jessica Alba, not a similar hair. I know. She's a little smaller.
I think
actually, she's a lot smaller.
I think
he's 9 feet tall, so.
On that note, I think if my character from Gilmore Girls was on Supernatural, he'd look at Jensen and go, "You're kind of short for a dean."
Old Shorty over here, guys. That's me. I think that Alec would probably adapt pretty well to the supernatural world, seeing as how he was living in a post-apocalyptic world, and he was a genetically modified human being.
Did he know that the Winchesters started the apocalypse?
I don't think he cared. So, yeah.
Thank you so much, I love you.
Thank you.
Hey there.
I'm Juliet.
Hi.
My question is, if Sam stayed at Stanford and continued law school after Jessica's death, what would the brothers, where would the brothers be in life, and what would their relationship be like?
I think Sam would probably be doing a lot of work trying to expunge Dean of all the felonies, misdemeanors, murders. I think he'd be like, impersonating federal agents.
Credit card fraud.
Speeding. Yeah. Yeah. Credit card fraud. Ball fights. Yeah. Grand Theft Auto. So I think Sam would be.
It's a charmed life.
Sam would be trying to get him out of trouble, saving him in a different way.
Aww.
And.
Ha 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 ha
I don't trust any
name.
What?
I'm teasing. Did you answer?
I didn't answer. I don't even know what's happening right now. Freaking Twilight Zone.
If Sam had gone to Stanford,
right,
to become a lawyer,
Dean would be in jail.
Thank you, Julia.
Hi there.
Hi, I'm Katie.
Hi, Katie. Hi, Jared.
My question's for Jared, and it's...
That's me!
Would you consider So Get This to be Sam's catchphrase?
So Get This?
I lost my shoe.
You said that once.
So Get This.
That's true.
So Get This.
That is, yeah. Yeah, I think so. For one of the seasons, I think the first, so in almost every episode, we have, like, we call it the exposition scene, which is the one where it's, so get this. One season it was, according to the lore, because I think every episode, for the first 9 episodes, I have like, okay, Dean, according to the lore. So from here on out, so get this. So get this. Anyway, so get this.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Maddie.
And Maddie, Jared.
Just in case.
I was watching LARP and the Real Girl, and some of you guys, like, completely just LARPed, and Dean had a lot of fun with it, obviously. And I was wondering if you guys had fun with it, and if you would consider doing that, like, in real life.
It was a ton of fun. I also, until I fell on my fence.
Then it was amazing. I spent my childhood going to Renaissance festivals.
Everybody spent their childhood going to Renaissance festivals. Did you dress up?
I don't know. I don't think I had really costumes.
I'll do it. I'll dress up next time. I'm myth busted.
Leather pants are difficult to move in. Because they were actual leather pants. Were you in leather pants?
Oh. I don't know why you just wear your own.
I should have.
I don't even know what I was wearing. I don't know. Scrubs.
Party!
Similar Renaissance fairs. My wife is a big Renaissance fair junkie and has in recent years forced me to slightly dress up. Part of my duty, I guess, at this point. She has this like tail. It's like a horse's tail. Have you guys seen
these? What is this dress pass?
Have you seen these? Like the Renaissance with the big long horse's tails? It's like you can never mind. Anyway.
What?
Next question.
No. What?
It's like this. Next question.
What?
I don't know. You know, there's. Oh, jeez. Get down, raise it, bring that down, go down, go down.
I've long said that the year Supernatural is over.
Let me rephrase. 2042.
Let me rephrase that. The first time I ever don't have to go to Comic-Con to work, I can go to play. I'm going as Boba Fett. So would you see a giant Boba Fett walking around?
I was going to say, you mean giant Boba Fett?
It's me. It's this guy.
Chewbacca
yourself, Chewie. All right, where were we? Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good. Doing good. Jamie. My question is, why do you guys always, like, torture Misha on set?
It's not that we torture him on set, it's just that we torture him everywhere, but it makes it the camera on set. I think the main reason is that Jensen and I long ago figured out, much like the Winchester brothers, that if we start pranking each other, it'll escalate, and neither one of us will be safe, but we still have that mischief in our body, and so as soon as Misha came along, we were like, woohoo!
Well, it really boils down to the fact that it's just fun to pick on the new guy. And he's still the new guy.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks. Hi.
Hi, I'm Cameron. I'm just wondering, Jensen, since you were originally going to be casted as Sam, and since Sam has played many different personas, like, Lucifer and Gadriel, is there any role that you, like, wish you had played if you had been Sam?
I never played Crowley.
Crowley? What? You know, I would say that there's no form of Sam that I would want to try to play. I think he's got that taken care of. I will say that there were some performances that I was jealous of that he got such really good stuff. Lucifer. What was the when you're talking to yourself in the mirror? I was thinking of the white suit Lucifer. Okay, the Lucifer. I'm trying to make it more difficult on myself, right? I think that was some really, really good writing. I think you did a great job. I was jealous of that. I wouldn't want to try to redo that because it was done the way it should have been done. So.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi, I'm Veronica.
Hi, Veronica. This is Jared.
She knows that.
Well, we don't have nice things, Jared.
My chair is angled. And it's ripped.
Can we get Jared a non-angled chair? Is that... You blame it on the chair. That's...
Hi, Veronica.
Okay, what's the question?
I want to know, what was the last lie you told?
The last lie that...
The last lie you told.
The lie I tell myself every day is that I don't have to write it down to remember it. Yeah, what was that fun? Yeah, I got it. 30 seconds later, I don't got it. What is it? So that I tell myself that lie.
Jared asked me how he looked backstage.
Oh.
I said, great. What? Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Shannon, and I was wondering if you could pick one person, dead or alive, that hasn't been on Supernatural and is not in your family, who you'd like to guest star on Supernatural, and what your favorite season is of Supernatural.
Will you write that down for me? So, dead or alive, but can't have been on the show, can't be a member of our family, and what was... And
they can be dead, they could be a person who's...
They could be dead and alive?
Away, or they could be alive. And what's your favorite season?
I love that. To clarify, she goes, yes, so they can be dead, or they can be alive. And what's my favorite season? We had a season discussion the other day. I've really loved the last couple seasons, but I will always have a soft space in my heart for season 4. Probably for obvious reasons.
I probably agree with him on 4. Although, I like 9 and 10 too.
I love 8.
Yeah.
What was the worst season?
6? 7?
11?
I mean, there's a lot of very talented people that, you know, we would love to work with. You know, you can go huge movie stars to friends of ours.
Me.
That rhyme. To see them. I don't know. What?
Tom would be fun on the show. We'll find out now.
Yeah.
Marmaduke?
Bill Shatner.
Woo!
Yeah!
I'll second that.
I think it's about time, bro.
The original captain. Yeah. Let's go with Shat.
There you go.
Alright, thank you.
Thank you.
Hi,
Although, are we sure that he's dead or alive?
I think he can be both or either.
It's like Weekend at Bernie's at this point, I think, isn't it? Just kidding, Bill. Nothing but love.
Hi, I'm Cynthia. My question is, would you rather be ugly and live forever, or attractive and die in a year?
Ugly and live forever.
Is that the same for you, Jensen?
Absolutely.
All right. I also want to say thank you for being such an inspiration to me.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you. You know what, though? Not to get too
deep. Oh, here we go.
Not to get too deep, and I haven't been watching vampire movies, but living forever could be really painful. You know, you have to lose everybody, and then meet more people and lose them again. It's supernatural. Just a thought. Just food for thought. Talk amongst yourselves.
Hi.
Hi, my name's Kim, and my question is, like, when you're filming, you have certain reactions to things. Do you feel like people have the same reaction?
What do you mean?
Like, in certain episodes, you feel like your character is supposed to portray a certain way. Do you feel that fans get that?
I think so. If you're asking what I think you're asking, I think a lot of what draws people into a TV show is to kind of mesh with the characters and the storylines. I think a lot of the stuff that Sam and Dean have gone through and are currently going through, this is my assumption, though obviously we're doing it on a kind of fantastic mythological scale, I think the struggles are still very universal, right? And so I think Sam and Dean kind of being up against the wall and deciding to keep fighting is what I think a lot of people in this room have gone through. I feel like that's what unites an audience and a cast and a you know, a crew as well. But I think so. I hope so.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks. Hey.
Hi, Nuisance Squirrel.
What's it?
I just said, hi, Nuisance Squirrel.
Hi.
My question is, earlier you said you were going back to like the original mythology type stuff, and I was wondering if we are going to get an incubus or a succubus on the show.
Yeah, are we going to? don't know.
Incubus be a VW bus. Still got it. Up top. All right.
Be under the bus. What would you like to see?
I would like to see both. Maybe like a couple.
A couple?
An incubus succubus couple.
I don't know. I don't know what that is.
You don't know what an incubus is? Or a succubus?
No. What's a succubus?
Is it like a German car?
No, succubi are a vampire subbreed that feeds off the sexual energy produced by other people.
Oh, yeah.
It's a German car. All day.
It was a siren.
I'm confused. That's a French call, right?
not as good.
We'll angle for it. We'll try and get all the German cars possible.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So get this.
What's been your favorite part about working for Supernatural?
That's a big question. With very small words.
Sorry.
Talk about yourself. That's a big question. I mean, for me, it's the relationships that have been built. Friends, family, literally family. We had, a lot of times on a Friday night, at the end of the day, we'll go either to the camera trailer or to the makeup trailer and have a drink, just to kind of say, you know, week well done. And we did it a couple days ago. And it was Spate's first day directing, and we had our crew, and we were in the camera truck, all having a drink, and then Jensen and I had to take off, right, to make a flight. And we kind of looked at each other, and we were like, man, you can't recreate this. Like, we have family from the show, and you guys, right? So, I think it's a relationship.
Yeah, I think that's, I mean, obviously he found his wife,
Oh yeah, that too, I meant my wife.
Yeah. He found his role model. So, those are invaluable things, I think, that he's certainly made, you know, cool.
Well said.
Free haircuts.
Free clothes.
Free clothes.
Misha.
Yes, that would go on the con. The pros and cons. Con.
Impala.
Misha. Yes, relationships would certainly be the greatest thing. Both family, our friends, you guys. That has certainly been, I think, the biggest reward that we've gotten from the 10 years of the show.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, not only are you both amazing actors, you're both amazing fathers as well. And I was wondering if you had any stories of being a father you could share with us.
That's a great story. That's a great question. Great story. First off, thank you. What's a good story?
Hitting your son in the eye with the tarantula.
No, it's not. It was a tyrannosaurus. Yeah, that's an interesting one. So, some of you probably heard the story, but I'll retell it because it's kind of, you know, for those who have kids, there's nothing like it. There's no love that compares to how you feel. You see, And I was with my older son Tom, and we were at the playground. It was in Vancouver. I think I had a late call, and so we went for a walk. It's like a year or two ago. And Tom had this Tyrannosaurus that I probably should have bought him when he was 7 or 8, you know, because it was like hard plastic and had a little tail, like the horse tail. And I would give him his Tyrannosaurus, and he would throw it down the slide, and I'd be like, Thomas, what are you doing? And I'd give it to him, he'd throw it down the slide, and it was killing him. That was the funniest thing in the world. And it was like the most amazing father-son time, just playing, and he thinks he's playing a little trick on daddy, and I'm going, quit doing that, and I give it back to him. And then for some reason, after probably 6 or 7 times of doing this, I decided that instead of walking the Tyrannosaurus back up to him at the top of the slide and handing it to him, that I was going to slide it up the slide. I still actually get really emotional thinking about it. So I slide it up, and one of those, like, and then as soon as I did it, he kind of, like, crouched down, bounced the T-Rex, which was not meant to slide up the slide, believe it or not, bounced off the slide and hit him somewhere in the face. And he immediately covered his eyes. My knees went, like, I buckled, and Jen had to run up. Like, I was like, I just threw a Tyrannosaurus in my son's eye. I gathered my wits about me, went up, and there was a dot right here where the tail of the Tyrannosaurus had actually hit him and cut him. He was fine. But that moment of like, oh my God, like, oh my God. Like, and I told a buddy of mine who's a dad, and he's like, yeah, you're gonna have about 12 of those. Where, yeah, at least, I guess, especially with boys, where you just go like, oh God, I I'm learning on the job, is what I'm trying to say. I'm trying. There's no lack of love. I'm trying my damnedest.
I'll give you a small one. This is new. So JJ's a toddler, and we're now starting to implement the timeout rule.
On Jensen, not on JJ.
And the other day, she was doing something she wasn't supposed to be doing, and I go, JJ? JJ. Is that me? And she's like, and she turns and looks at me, and she's like that total guilty look, and I'm like, do you need to go to timeout? And she goes, okay. And walks over, and just heads out. I'm like, I wasn't gonna send you, but okay. It's like she enjoyed it. I'm like, oh, joke's on me. Okay. Let's see how this is gonna go. 1 point for you. Dad, 0. So that's I have to look forward to now.
Jen will leave me with the kids every now and again, which she started to do less and less of when she finds out what I do with the kids. So she'll call, like she was at a bachelorette party or a baby shower or something. She was gone for a couple nights. And so she'd call, it'd be like 9:30 a.m. She's like, so how was breakfast? I was like, oh, it was great. She's like, you haven't had breakfast yet, have you? I'm like, no. She's like, what are the kids doing? Right here in bed with me, watching the iPad. She's like, get up, make the breakfast, get him out of the house.
So, okay, boys, who wants ice cream breakfast?
So, and my 3.5-year-old tells on himself. He'd be like, Tom, did you hit your brother? He'd be like, I did. Why'd you hit your brother? He goes, in the head. You know, like, so he certainly tells on daddy as well. So Jen gets back, and he's like, yeah, we have pancakes, we have like ice cream, we have candy. And I was like, and she was, I had to take her for a walk or something. She was like, just make sure you put shoes on their feet. Yeah.
That's a simple request.
What's it?
That's a simple request.
A simple request. So I did it. Thinking, oh, we'll be gone for an hour. We were only gone for an hour, but the pictures that were taken and posted online last forever and show my kids without shoes. Jen's like, I told you to put shoes on. Anyways, learning on the job. Thank you.
Hi there.
Yeah, you got it.
Hi, my name's Melody and I'm from Wisconsin. Hi. tonight, so my question pertains to football. I heard you
were a
fan. So, if Sam, Dean, and Charlie were to play against Rowena, Crowley, and Kane, who do you think would win, and what positions would they hold on their team?
Wait, Crowley, Kane, and Castiel?
No, Crowley, Kane, and Rowena.
Well, Sam would definitely be a tight end. Nope, not gonna laugh at that. More like a split end. That's a good question. Would they have their powers?
It's up to you, I guess.
Well, I say no. Because that only helps them.
I got it. Sam would be the quarterback. Kane would be the quarterback. They could just have a hair off. Crowley would be the running back. Dean would be the running back. Because we could advance the ball. Charlie and Rowena would be the coaches because we all know women really call the shots. Thankfully, doesn't require me to worry about any of that. You know what I mean? I'm able to just focus on Sam and what Sam wants, and what Sam's doing. So, you know, we're just one cog in the wheel. So, luckily, the people around us are outrageously talented and getting better by the day. Around us, not around me. Everybody's getting a lot better, more comfortable with what they do. I'd say it's gotten easier because the technology has advanced. You know, for the first several seasons, we were shooting 35mm film. So, you know, we'd have rollouts and we'd have to change the mags and we'd have to, you know, there's all this kind of stuff that you have to do. Now we shoot digital, we can just, you know, go on forever. And if, you know, if it's bad, you just keep going, throw another SD card in there. And it's so that's, I think, really, the advancement of technology has given us a lot more freedom and has made the jobs of the film technicians, I think, smoother and easier. Even, I was talking about this earlier, a visual effects department. We used to have to do a lot of stuff on green screen. We don't do that anymore. They can actually put all that stuff in practically while we're shooting in a set.
That's pretty incredible, because we used to, you're right, everything flows a lot more smoothly. When we were shooting film, they would shoot like 1,000-foot magazines. And so we'd be, you know, it would take twice as long to shoot because they were bigger, they were heavier. You'd have to pull them out, put them back in, check the gate. So there's a term called check the gate. And what they would do is when the film's rolling, every now and again a sliver would come off. And so if you do like a 5-minute scene and they go check the gate and they see a sliver has fallen off, you have to do the scene all over again, or a hair or whatever it might be. So everything's just going much more smoothly. Yeah, I hope it translates. I'm down.
Cool. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
What?
It's in the room. Oh, it's in the room.
What y'all talking about? Next question. Hi there.
Hi. My name's Alex.
Hi, Alex.
So my question is, what's the nicest thing a fan has ever done for you?
A fan has ever done?
Yeah.
Oh, man. That's tough. There's some very amazingly generous and artistic and intelligent and thoughtful fans out there that have done a lot for us.
Yeah, that's a really, really difficult question.
It's not a cop-out answer, but I do have an answer. That inspired us. The inspiration.
Inspire us, and one of the things that I love about with the fans, and it's not really for me, but when the family helps raise money for charities, raise awareness, be there for other fans, I'll flip through, it's very difficult to flip through Facebook, because when I post something, immediately it's like 1,000-somethings, but I'll try and flip through it, and I'll see people in the fandom reaching out to one another, and they've never even met. You know, they'll hear somebody say like, hey, I've never met you, but you know, if you're ever in Ohio, you know, maybe it was y'all who wrote it. But no, reaching out and helping others. I mean, that's kind of the idea of Supernatural, and that's what we've also tried to kind of engender. Thank you.
This question.
Yeah, that's right.
Do you?
And I love you too.
Misha?
Hi.
My name's Ruby. I'm not
no way.
Not the demon.
Thank you for clarifying.
I'm sorry, I'm trying not to cry right now. I wanted to know what your favorite cheesy pickup line is.
My cheesy pickup line?
I lost my shoe!
I know his cheesy pickup line. You ever seen Supernatural? Mine is, hey, I lost my number. Can I have yours?
Oh!
I think the greatest cheesy pickup line I've ever used is Jared Padalecki. Where are you going? Where are you? Jared, why are you leaving?
I thought you were tired. You put your hand. I'm not interested.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, that brings us to the last question.
Come on up.
Last question. This is last question.
Isabella, have a seat, Emma and Isabella. What is your question?
What is your iPhone passcode? 8585. Is it?
If Cass needed to inhabit a new vessel for whatever reason, would Sam or Dean allow him to use them?
Ooh. Oh!
I didn't see that. Cass needed to inhabit a new vessel.
I'm making it somebody else.
Yeah.
Get somebody else? That's what you'd say?
Yeah.
I still need clarification. I still don't have that.
So Sam, if Cass needed a new vessel, right, would Sam and he allow Cass to use them, him as a vessel?
Yes.
I think Sam's had really bad experiences being possessed. The first angel that he let possess him was Lucifer. The second one was Gabriel.
My bad.
Neither of them.
I wear that one. My bad.
I think Sam would probably say no.
Die if you
let him burn. If Cass was going to die, the only way was to let him inhabit one of us.
But then Dean would be dead.
Nope. Hang on. I got it. Baby.
Right?
Yeah, totally. So you'd be
alright. Yeah,
then
we wouldn't have to look at him.
We'd be
like
Night Rider.
Yeah, we'd be like Night Rider.
Exactly.
Guys, thank you.
Guys, thank you very much. Thank
that
you.
Was.
Thank you so much for letting us down to hang out with you. We love you all very much. It's always fun to come here. You guys, these coasters, you rock. Thank you.